Even if he doesn't have any more time for it today, Steve Lindsay hopes that one day he will return to racing. For more than 10 years, he was a racing driver and tested cars. During all that time, he was quite unaware that he was using a technological principle that would one day radically change his life. The engine of his car ignited a mixture of petrol and compressed air. A turbocharger on the engine used compressed air for added performance. And without compressed air, the tires on his racing car could never have been inflated. In fact, our daily lives are full of applications that work with compressed air and with compressors that produce it.
I think compressors are really interesting because, to be honest, to begin with, I didn't know a great deal about compressors, like many people. And then I read somewhere that 10% of electricity that's used by industry within Europe, across all industry, goes into compressors. It's a fantastically high figure. And I realized that if you could make a difference to that, you could potentially make a big difference to energy usage across Europe.
With clever engineering, Lindsay wants to design a new compressor. Above all, it should be more energy efficient. Lindsay studies patents and learns about the inventions of past decades. And then he realizes that to achieve his goal, he needs to think quite differently. The previous type of compressor, which is still in use, is the piston compressor. Here, an engine drives a piston inside a cylinder. When the piston slides downwards, air flows into the cylinder. When it is pushed upwards, the air is compressed, producing compressed air. The problem here, only half of the energy used produces compressed air. The compressor wastes the other half when it sucks air back in. Even though the principle has been continuously improved, there has not been a real breakthrough so far.
Ours is the first new compression technology, which is inherently oil-free, it leaks less, and so we have a unique combination of attributes which gives you a machine which is more efficient and, surprisingly, is cheaper to produce.
To achieve this goal, Lindsay has to think long and hard. He knows that an energy-saving compressor would have to operate continuously in rotary motion and function better than anything else so far.
It's long been recognized that rotary motion is good for compressors, but traditional rotary compressors suffer very badly with sealing where they seal along a single line. Our geometry uniquely allows you to seal across a broad area, and this gives you a lot less internal leakage, which gives you a more efficient machine, but also a machine that you can run oil-free, and a machine, if you choose, you can run more slowly for long reliability.
Steve Lindsay hires a small team of engineers. The inventor writes his own software, which enables him to virtually design and test his idea. After hundreds of tests and calculations, the design of the new compressor is finally ready. The originally straight cylinder of the piston compressor becomes a circular tube, resembling a donut. The piston inside becomes a blade that rotates continuously. Behind the blade, air is constantly sucked in. As soon as the blade passes the suction opening, a rotating disc blocks the circular cylinder. Now all the air is compressed in front of the blade until it is released through a valve. The blade slips through the slot in the rotating disc again and compresses the next load of air. The compressor sucks air in and compresses it simultaneously.
After we'd built a number of virtual prototypes, our first real-world application went into the Worcester wastewater plant, a real site in Severn Trent Water in the UK, and there it ran and showed an astonishing 21% reduction in electricity usage, a true step change in energy usage from a relatively simple change.
In future, Steve Lindsay wants to license the patented technology with his company, Lontra. But he also wants to make compressors himself. Several new prototypes are already being tested. More will follow. Basically, there are no limits to the use of Linz's blade compressors.
I think the exciting thing about compressors is that they're behind nearly every part of modern life. From the compressor that opens the doors on a train or a bus, to the compressors that power the tools in factories or power the spray guns in factories, to compressors in air conditioning or in the back of your fridge. And our compressor can potentially replace all of them over time.
Steve Lindsay estimates that the blade compressor could save approximately 2 terawatt-hours of energy in Europe every year, the consumption equivalent of a city with 200,000 inhabitants. If he has success with his compressor, he'll probably take time off to do a few more laps on the circuit. Then he can indulge in wasting a bit of energy again too.